but is that one you might mention, is that actually right on the base, or was it near the base? Because I remember there was a hotel, I'm trying to think of the name of it, that was near the Air Force base and near the museum that we stayed with Jeff one time. I don't know if you were there, Mike, but I know that my friend from work, if you recall, John, not a ham, but John Yee, had stayed with myself and Jeff, N8MCC, and so that was interesting. And just in case you guys hadn't heard it, because Mike, you and Steve might not have, I'm sure Al has heard it, but George, if you hadn't heard, passed away a couple of weeks ago, WBATIV George, that we would hear on the Saturday mornings oftentimes, passed away at 92. And sad to have to let you guys know about that, but that is the case. So, alrighty, let me move it along, and I will turn it back to you, Al. So, K8WXQ to take it from NABWB in the group.
Yeah, K8WXQ, okay, yeah. Yeah, it's because I'd be selling, I'll probably be setting up over there near that building, or, you know, where the new stuff is. Possibly. I think that's the south side of it. That one building they have open. They have a lot of new stuff in there, and I usually set up the south side of that. But I'm not ready right now. Things have just not been transpiring properly here with so many, you know, so many things happening. And I just haven't had the time. But we'll get there. I'm hoping that I can get enough. I got to see what I got available and what I want to haul down there and set up a couple tables, I guess, outside. Hopefully the weather will cooperate. It won't be so hot like it was last year. Wow. Well, you remember last year, I went through about 3-4 bottles of water. It was brutally hot. But there were quite a few people there just the same, but they went through a lot of water. So I'm hoping it's not hot. I never remembered Monroe, especially early morning. I've never remembered that hot, or that to be hot in early morning. Usually by about 10:30, it'll start warming up, maybe up to 75, 80. I have seen it get that high. But usually in the morning, it's nice and cool. It's usually under 72 degrees. And usually, I've been there enough to know that you got to be set up and selling at 7 o'clock at that time. And, boy, that means getting up really early. I'll have to be ready to go. And then you got time to get down there. You got to get in line and get your spot and get your tables out and everything. So doing all that really, really early. But I think that goes 7 to 12 or something. I don't know. I might be wrong on all that. We have to check the schedule. But I won't have time to go to the restaurant. I remember we all went to a restaurant, I think, last year and had a breakfast before we went over to the fairgrounds there in Monroe. But anyways, got a pretty hectic June coming up with that swap, and I've got about 4 doctor's visits. I've got to go to the VA hospital. They want to see me over there get the set up in their system. Just regardless if I go to the St. Joe Hospital or not, they want to coordinate the doctors there with the doctor at you know, near St. Joe that I go to. So they have to coordinate the health care. They don't want me to go one place and get one treatment and go to the other doctor and get something else done. So they need to communicate. So that I got that to do in June. And so many things. It just seems like it's like a light switch. It seems like the 1st of May, it turns the light switch on and it doesn't quit till the end of September. And I had to get the tractor back together, all kinds of projects on here. man, I want to get a ride on this scooter. I got to get the Huffy, Harley, I call it. I got to get that out because I want to sell that. And I don't know, I'll put it out front here. I'll put a chain around it and lock it up and maybe put it out here in front and see if somebody wants to buy it off of me. But anyway, I think I'm going to probably wrap it up here, and I don't have anything further. Okay, Mike on the K4, I did not know that they were going to come out with a K4. Seems like we just all upgrade and think we got something. You got the F, which is even better, and then now they're coming out with a K4. I'm just wondering if they stayed with the same panel. It's just changed the internal for some all new dashboard. So, I guess over to you, Mike. I'll say hello to Judy. I hope you guys are getting by. It sounds like you're turning into a farmer there or something. You got your gardening skills going at it. You got a beautiful house there. You got a lot of outdoor stuff to take care of. I did some sitting today. I got the front bushes all trimmed up really nice, so that and the car. So I try to accomplish one or two things a day when I get up. And I've been doing laundry as well. For you, Mike, I guess I'll wrap it up and say, I think I'll say 73s on this. Looks like it's 736, so I'll probably wrap it up here and for this week. I've been playing the Hammond organ a little bit, too. I'm having a blast with that. So, Al Playroom. Now you guys know why my ham shack is out in the garage. All my toys are out here. And I've been working with my mill a little bit, making some projects that I'm working on. Working on a power supply right now for an H23B kit for Todd, maybe 8IT up there in Howell. He's had some problems with had some soldering issues with his soldering iron. He didn't get that thing quite like it should be. He wanted to get it over here and have me do it right, so make sure that all the solder joints are going. We've gone through 4 5146 tubes already on this. I let him do it. I offered to put the board in and got power supply for him, but he wanted to do it. So he got his shot. So do you, Mike. 73 today. We'll talk again next week. C88IMG in the group, C8WSQ.
Yeah, Roger. Okay, very good, Al. If you haven't seen it, check your email that I sent earlier. The Radio Amateur Maestro. Check it out when you get a chance. From 2 years ago, I just resent it. I came across it, and I was looking for some of the pictures I sent out. The restaurant is Dina's restaurant there in Monroe that we went to last year. And the picture of Steve and Larry was from the year before, just so that you're aware of when they were taken. And Steve Stoltz, the Italian restaurant that you couldn't remember, that I did look up for him because he caught me when I was outside working the garden. Is Mama Di Salvo is the restaurant that we went to. And funny enough, he sent me a picture. You recall that he was really into the carbonara pasta, which quite often is not on the menu. And so he sent me a picture of this dish complete with the flour right in the middle of the pasta. It was pretty cool. So anyway, I did see the email activity there on George Larry. I didn't realize, I thought he was maybe 86 or 84 or something like that. I didn't realize he was 92. And I'm not sure when he passed away from, I think it had something to do with Further comments, and I will send it to you, Steve.